evening, wherever you're watching me from. Again, this is Bolakom from Bolakom the Production. Coming to you with a story of dedication to my man, Thon Chual. He goes by the name Thon Moses Chual. Thon and I are members of Duquesne community, growing up in a very difficult time in our history as children. We went to Boomer Primate School together, and we took different routes intellectually and did great things with our own individual life, and of course everything else has become history. For quite some time I felt the need and obligation to acknowledge his personal contribution to our society and as well to his own family. Thon represents the best in us in the areas of intellectual capacity. He's an advocate for peace and justice, and he has done a lot of great things in his own personal life concerning Sudan and views on social issues and political issues. He has been the face that we best represent Duquesne society in Washington D.C. Thon has always been interested in providing services to serve the interests of his own community as well as himself. I spent a great deal searching for things that I can find about Thon Moses, and I came up with some few things, and I thought it was very interesting to put it in a 15-minute video, since nobody in America or elsewhere have enough time to watch 30-minute, 2 hours documentary. I thought it was just important that I put it in a very simple framework to show other communities that few individuals do love their communities above themselves, and Thon is an example of that. So without wasting enough time and too much lecturing or too much stories to tell about Thon, I'll let you see the Thon that I knew and the Thon that is my friend. I'll let you share the excitement part up to why it came to my heart as a very important topic of this session. I'll let you also see some of few sessions Thon had in U.S. Congress, in the media, in referendum, in things that he have done behind the scene, few people barely knew about. So sit back and relax, and if you ever like what you just watched from Akumdit Production, how about you just leave me information on my Yahoo message, and I'll be more than happy to improve in areas that need improvement and to continue to upgrade my abilities to be able to do things in a way that meet the 21st century production status. So again, thank you so much, and God bless you, and thanks again for taking your time to watch.
There comes a time when we heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying, oh, and it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all. We can't go on pretending day by that someone somewhere will soon make a change. We all are part of God's great big family. and the truth. You know love is all we need.
My name is Thorn Achol. I'm from South Sudan. I came to this country as a minor. I was 17 years old when I was brought by Lutheran Immigration and Refugee Service, and I was placed through one of their affiliates, Bethany Christian Services, in Grand Rapids, Michigan. So coming to America, I was already excited that this was a moment for myself to transform my life and also to begin a new life in a new country that, you know, will be my own home. What really made a huge difference was my social worker. And that social worker was the one that was looking after my general welfare. But I think the bottom line, what really made a huge difference was the foundation that was laid for me. In 2009, it was an advocacy day, and I think Lutheran, called Michigan, and they said, do you guys have a client that might come and participate? So my former supervisor, when I was in care, actually called me in DC and said, look, there is a program going on, so I'm going to connect you with someone in the DC office. So that's how I was linked with the Lutheran. I came in to just come and help advocate. And from that day, that was just the beginning. So that was the day that I could connect with LRS, and that was the work that has always been in my heart. You know, when you look at the LRS, you know, the vision, you know, their mission statement, you know, embrace, empowerment, welcoming, those kind of stuff. So for them, they have had an opportunity to welcome me to the U.S. They were able to embrace me. They were able to empower me. So all of that translate not only the resettle me, but they were also translating the same thing to help me go back to my country. So being part, at the time I was already, you know, in the board with LRS. I was already involved with the advocacy work. I was already involved in so many areas. So for them, you know, positioning refugees in the center of their work and enable us to empower myself and be able to do all kind of advocacy work on the Hill that I've been doing with LRS staff. For the most part of my life, I have lived as a refugee. And to have an opportunity to sit among people that not only they come to do the work, but they have a heart and passion for what they do. So for me to be among people that really just all they think of is that person in darkness, is that person that is struggling, is that person that is in turmoil, is that person that has been displaced, is that person that is struggling. That's something that I have been very, very fortunate to be a client. And then today serving a leadership capacity really has made me look at LRS as an organization that not only in a refugee camp. We came from a very communal background whereby we value family unit. And we Sudanese, we have a very strong culture.
Ooh, South Sudanese, it's a lot of things. What comes first the struggle that we had to go through.
I came as a result of civil war, and coming to this country, I was coming to start all over again, you know, and I was very fortunate enough that I'm here today. I was part of the group that was known as Lost Boys from Sudan. And then I was resettled a few years back by Lutheran Immigration Refugee Service in the state of Michigan, where I was placed as a foster child. My dream came true that, you know, I excel and I'm doing very well today as a result of contribution, global contribution, and the people that brought me to this country. I was able to finish my studies. So currently I'm working for the DC government. Many people come to this country to start a new life. There's a million of refugees who are still in situations that are hard, you know, in regard to protection, in regard to resources, in regard to mental health.
The point of World Refugee Day is it's the one day of the year where organizations and activists and refugees all over the world come together to try to elevate the visibility of the reality of refugees. And it's very different depending on where you are. In the US, it's a lot of organizations coming together and trying to raise awareness and visibility using the arts or using performance or doing advocacy on the Hill.
It's an awareness day for some of the refugees who are still in the same situation. So for myself, I'm celebrating the kind of assistance that I got, as well as also the help and assistance that was extended to me over the years.
That fills us with joy because it took us 50 years to actually let the whole world know that we are people who endured so much and suffering under the regime of the North Sudan. And finally, now that we have our independence, we want to walk tall and proud.
Let us pray together. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this fellowship, for bringing us together. Celebrate the first day of Chol, but we committed Chol to you,
so that we will. Amen. We know the big picture of why we are Sudanese. We know our identity, we know our heritage, we know our history, and there are certain things that bring us together as Sudanese.
I think the most difficult thing is the cultural change that happens to the children. A lot of parents find it very hard to try to keep the children still sticking to their cultural, you know, Sudanese culture.
This is just a spinach with peanut butter sauce. And you eat it with the Egyptian bread, injera.
Laugh to laugh. It doesn't matter how hard time we go through. You will see us laughing at the hardest time. We don't have money, we are not rich people, but we are happy people.
People who come to the United States who have endured the worst kinds of trauma you can imagine, and yet they get up every day and they try to learn a new language and fit into a new culture, and many of them thrive, because if you have the power to leave everything, cross borders, flee in the middle of the night, save your family, you're a pretty strong, hardy person.
I had a hope always, even when I was in exile, I had a hope that...
Good in the sense that, you know, you have a job that is part of your history, you know, because the referendum was not even about a job, but it was about being part of the history, you know, because the issues in Sudan started before I was born. And, you know, coming to the last lap, it's like the last person that is running with the baton trying to win, you know, the championship. So we were like at the winning end, having opportunity to work together and having all these big dreams of, oh, this is what our country will look like tomorrow, you know. So we all can't wait for January the 9th to see what comes next. So it was having each other and having the same language of what we expect out of January 9th.
This is the best time for us to have our country, because we have people who are ready to actually build this country.
This thing is coming to an end. And then if this referendum goes the way we are hoping, then there might be peace, because peace is what we want.
It came in my generation. I was born during the wartime, and this is the right time for me to show the world that I'm ready to do whatever I can to save my country.
My hope for Sudan is for us to, you know, to achieve, for us to be our own, in order to govern ourselves, to be a separate country, and improve our country, you know, develop our country.
This is about deciding the destiny. Your destiny, the destiny of your grandchildren, is the destiny of the future, and lay in your hand And it's not something that can be entrusted to an individual. It is something that, given the opportunity that we have right now, let us come out and fight.
There comes a time when we heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one. The greatest gift of all. We can't go on pretending day by day that someone somewhere will soon make a change. We all are part of God's great big family, and the truth, you know, love is all we need.